Hi, Tony Vernetti here with Enphase Energy. Welcome to the first of a series of educational videos for homeowners in California who are considering investing in solar. If you live in California and you looked into solar in 2023 or later, you've probably heard about how the big electric utilities in California have changed the way that they compensate homeowners with solar systems for the energy that they supply to the grid. You may have heard the terms NEM 3.0 or the net billing tariff. These are new terms to all of us, and you might be hearing about them for the first time from different solar companies, and it could all seem a little confusing. In this video, I'll break down how solar billing in California works now, and hopefully clear up any confusion you might have. First, let's review how a solar energy system works. Solar systems are comprised of solar panels and an inverter system. Solar panels produce DC, or direct current electricity. The inverter system converts DC to AC, or alternating current electricity, which is compatible with your home's electrical system and the utility grid. The electricity produced by your system feeds into your home's breaker panel, supplying power directly to your home. Now, here's a question. Since a solar system only produces electricity during the day, but you use electricity 24 hours a day, how can it even come close to eliminating your power bill? To answer that question, you need to know how solar power interacts with your home and the utility grid, and how solar billing works now. This bell curve represents energy production of a solar system on a typical sunny day. This is showing a 24-hour period from midnight to midnight the next day. Energy production begins in the morning after the sun rises and increases until it peaks midday, and then it declines as the sun sets. Now I'll overlay typical energy consumption throughout the day. As you can see, for about half of the hours of the day, the solar system isn't producing any energy, but the home is consuming energy. During the middle of the day, the solar system is producing a lot more energy than the home is actually using. So where does that excess electricity go? If you have only a solar system, the electricity feeds back to the utility grid. And now, the California electric utilities pay only a very small amount of money for this excess solar energy most hours of the day. As the solar system's energy production starts to decline as the sun goes down, as you can see, our energy consumption tends to increase as we come home from work or school, we turn the lights on, we cook dinner, we watch TV, etc. So if you have only a solar system, you end up buying a lot of electricity from the utility grid in the evening, and the price of electricity at this time is much higher than during the day because of time of use rates. In summary, the utilities don't pay much for excess solar now, and the cost of buying energy in the evening is high. Wouldn't it be great to figure out a way to use your own excess solar energy in the evening? Watch the next video in the series to find out how.